Let us discuss the direction of induced current in a coil due to electromagnetic induction. Here you can see there is a situation in which there is a circular coil on which an inward magnetic induction is applied. And here you can see if the magnetic induction increases with time, obviously the flux linked with the coil is changing, due to which an induced EMF is produced in it, which will cause a current to flow in the coil. Here you can see the carries a current, or a current is induced in anti-clockwise direction. This is because as magnetic field is increasing in inward direction, the current caused by the electromagnetic induction will flow in such a way so as to oppose the causes of induction. Here you can see as the current is flowing in anti-clockwise manner, it will start producing an outward magnetic induction which will oppose the downward increment of magnetic induction. The same phenomena we can see here in a practical situation. Here you can see a circular coil connected with a galvanometer and a bar magnet with its north pole facing toward the coil is brought close to the coil, and here you can see the magnetic field of north pole will be passing through the coil from right to left, and as the magnet comes close to the coil, the flux toward left through the coil is increasing, so it induces an anti-clockwise current in the coil, due to which its own magnetic induction is developed toward rightward direction, which will oppose the leftward increment of magnetic induction due to motion of magnet. Or you can say, as the magnet is brought close, here we can see the situation again. As the magnet is brought close, the coil induces a current in such a way that the facing end of the coil in front of the magnet also behaves like a north pole, and it will have a tendency to repel the magnet, as the two similar poles repel away from each other. So we can see the motion of magnet which is causing the flux change in the coil is being opposed by the induced current direction. Similarly, we can see a situation that is similar to the situation we already discussed. Here the magnetic induction is in inward direction and a circular coil is placed. But here we can see the magnetic induction gradually decreases with time. If it starts decreasing with time, you can see a clockwise current starts flowing in the coil, because the clockwise current produces an inward magnetic induction which will have a tendency to oppose the decrement in magnetic induction. And similar situation is here. You can see if there is a coil and close to the coil there is another coil placed, and in the first coil a battery is connected. And if we close down the switch, here you can see there exists a clockwise current in the first coil which produces a magnetic induction from right to left, because of which automatically a current is induced in the second coil. But after some time, when the current becomes constant, the current in second coil drops to zero because no change in magnetic induction is there. And initially there was a change because the flux was increasing from zero to a specific value. Now you can see what happens when the switch is opened. If we open the switch, the current drops to zero and magnetic induction of the first coil decreases. Now you can see in the second coil, current induces in the same direction as that of the first coil, because as the magnetic induction from right to left is decreasing, it is developing a magnetic induction in same direction so as to oppose the decrement. So this is quite an important phenomena. Again, you can see as the current drops to zero, the current finally in second coil also becomes zero, because now there is no change. So electromagnetic induction phenomena causes an EMF to be induced, or a current to be induced, only in the duration when the magnetic flux is changing. When the magnetic flux becomes constant, there exists no induced EMF or no induced current in the circuit. Let us discuss some more experiments to demonstrate electromagnetic induction and the direction of induced current understanding by using Lenz's law. Here we can see this is an electrical circuit in which a wire AB is connected with a battery and a rheostat along with a switch. And on the other side of the wire AB, there is a circular coil placed in the same plane of the wire. Now when the switch is closed, we can see in the loop of wire AB, a clockwise current flows. And as soon as current flows, wire AB, current in wire AB establishes a magnetic induction in the direction, in the outward direction in the region of this loop. And here we can see as soon as an outward direction magnetic induction increases due to the current in circuit, clockwise current is induced in the circular loop because if an outward direction magnetic induction increases, here we can see the current induced in the loop will be in such a way so as to decrease this increase in magnetic flux or magnetic induction. That's why it is in clockwise direction because current in coil itself produces a downward or inward magnetic induction. And in this situation, here you can see if the resistance of rheostat is decreased, we can see initially when the current is established, no magnetic flux change is there in the loop. So, no EMF or current is there in coil. But when the resistance of rheostat is decreased, here we can see the current in wire AB increases. And again, the outward magnetic induction through the loop due to wire AB increases. And again, it causes a current in clockwise direction. And here, if we decrease the resistance, we can see the current is in clockwise manner because of increase in magnetic field. Now, if we start increasing this resistance, see what happens. The current in the loop of wire AB start decreasing and the magnetic field also start decreasing. And due to which, an anti-clockwise current is induced in the loop in the coil because it produces its magnetic induction in outward direction, which will be opposing the decrement in this outward magnetic induction due to decrease in current by increasing a resistance. So, this experiment itself is a very good demonstration to understand the direction of induced current by Lenz's law and its verification also.